Okay, so this is the main stage four tier shoe rack. You can also make it a boot rack by removing one of the shelves, and they have given parts to do that. But for us, we keep our boots usually in our closet in front of the door. This is going to go in the garage. So whenever we usually come in car, right, and we come out of garage and we keep our shoes on the floor in the garage, we like to keep it here so that they're organized and much better, and you know, you don't fall down at night. You know, it's always nice to have shoes organized. It looks nice and it's easy to pick up. And it's really big one, so it's perfect for garage as well. So that's where we are going to keep it. I'm going to show you how to assemble it, and then I will also show you how it will look. So I removed the material, and the material is really, really nice. All the metals are really well perfect. I did not find any defects in any of those things. So let's start making this thing. So there are two things that you can make: shoe rack or boot rack. I'm going to make the shoe rack. Now, just starting with this thing, there is this three whole squares. These are needed for the boot rack. So you remove one of the shelves basically. Since I don't need the boot rack, I'm going to keep these two, that is the straight ones, on the side because I don't need it. Now, these are the five-way connectors, because you can see it has four pipes and one hole, so it's five total. So there are like eight of them and one extra. So it's like they are given a product for an extra one, which is nice, but I don't need it, extra one right now. So I'm going to keep it on the side. This is four-way connectors, right? You can see 1, 2, 3 and the fourth hole here. Once again, there are 16 of them and they have provided one extra. So I'm going to keep it on the side. So in total, because I'm making a shoe rack, I'm going to keep four of them on the side. Same was case for the boot rack. Only thing is you will use the these connectors of slightly less. That is either the fourth, either the, you will basically use the, these five-way connectors, you will lose two of less. So basically you will use those, the straight ones instead of these two. So at the end, you should have four extra, no matter whether you make a shoe rack or boot rack. Okay, then these are the six plugs, which just hide holes and stuff like that, which is really nice to have. Obviously, there are 16 big rods, medium rods and small rods. And then there are these things. Now, obviously, when you make a boot rack, you will not have one of these. Okay, so please do the way I have done it. I have arranged it as A, B, C, D, E, F, and G. So once you arrange it, you won't make mistakes. So please do this. It will be a time saver for you. Now I'm going to take two of these G's and one of this B, and I'm going to start connecting this. Okay, so let me correct this. As I said, E, F, G. So I will be taking these G ones. So there are like 16 of this and 8 of those medium rods, right? And two of each. So you will basically make a set of eight. So you will use two G's and one B's, and total you will be able to make eight of these. Okay, so now you can see I already made one, but I'm going to show you how to make this one. So you can see there are this four-way connectors has three pipes and one hole. So you want this hole to be on the top, and you are going to put this pipe like here, and same here on the other side, hole on the top. Okay, and you basically see the holes are on the top and the pipes are all outwards, down and this way, and you need to just press it. Please press it, and the reason for you need to press it both ways is otherwise it won't be aligned properly when you eventually connect everything. So just press it and then press it. You can see I just pressed it properly again and it went in. So if you do this, it will be much easier for you, and this is what you end up with. Like this, right? Same is this one. You can see I have made two of these. Now obviously I'm going to make six more of this. Okay, so you can see I put this thing, but not all of them will be aligned even when you press it. So to do it is put it on a normal ground floor, like, you know, hard floor, and then make it straight. That way, you know, it's aligned properly. And you can see I've aligned everything properly. And then what I'm doing is I'm going to keep it like this. So you can see how I have arranged all of eight of these things, so that you know you have not made a mistake. All the holes are showing up in proper direction. You could by mistake put this one in other hole. So please do this. Arrange it this way and it will make your life a lot more easier. So I have made eight of these, and I still have four of this medium sized rod left, which is expected, because there are 12 of these rods. Okay, now if you remember, there were 8 sets of this connector F, which is the 5 holes ones and 4 medium ones. I have connected 3 of them and I just wanted to show you the final one, right? So basically, this 5-way connector, right? You can see there are like 4 pipes and 1 hole. You want the hole to be standing up like this. And same with the hole, this one here, right? And you want both of them to be facing each other. And then you are going to take the medium B size pipe and you are going to connect it. So you can see, they both were facing each other and I am just putting the B pipe in between. And once again, pressing this thing here, pressing this thing here, putting it on the floor and aligning it. Just align it so it's flat on the surface. And then I'm going to place it like this. So you can see, now all of these are placed like this. And since they all face the same way, I know I have done it correctly. So, yeah. See, just press it. If you miss or press something, and when you align it, you can also see if something is not, has not went inside properly, which I just noticed. So please do that. And now I have this set ready. Okay, and you can see how I have aligned everything. If you do this, you won't make any mistakes. Now, pick one of these, right? The D, and take two of this big rod, the A ones, and just slide them in. You might need to put your thumb initially to make the hole a bit bigger, but once you do that, you can see the way I am doing it, and they should come out on the other side. There is a hole. It might, because of the stitching, it might stick a bit, but you know, same I am going to do this one here again. You can see I am putting my thumb. You will have some resistance coming out. This one I did bit, but not this one on the end. And I have made this first one. I am going to make 8 of this because there are 16 rods. So, and there are 8 of these things. I am going to make 8 of this. Right here. You know, on one on top of each other. Okay, so you can see how I have arranged everything. Now I am going to recommend you to do something. Press it and put it back. Just do it for all of them. It will take you like a minute, but it will save you a lot of time when you are doing this thing. Just press it. Put a lot of force if you need to. Just, you need a carpet so that you don't damage anything the way I am doing it. But just do this step and trust me, you will save so much time. You have no idea. Right? And you can see everything is the same size. Because then everything is not the same size if the rod is not completely inside. It will be out of sync with one another and it will be become a really, really difficult. You can see, I had done it once, but I'm now doing it again and it clicked up a little bit more. So I saved myself a lot of time. Trust me. I recommend that you do the same thing. Okay. So once you have done this thing, I'm showing it in the video because I know that a lot of people will like, you know, hey, I just did it. And then they will have trouble later on. So please, just do it with me and you will save yourself a lot of time. Cool. Now you can see I've arranged everything, right? Now it is very, very simple. What I need to do is, I'm going to take this. You can see these more ones, the ones that are a lot more. You are going to take one of these and you are going to place here. The holes are going to be on the top. The other one here facing it. Once again, holes are on the top. It's just, they're just facing each other. And this one, once again, holes are in the top and in between. Right? Let me keep this on the side. And now you're going to put these two of these on this side. So you see what I did? The 8 set that I had made, set of 8, I'm putting it on both the sides. And the set of 4 that I just made, that's going in the middle. In all the cases, holes are going to be on the top. So you see holes on the top, and holes on the top. Now, once you arrange it, it's very, very simple, right? Put it here like this. Now see, if you had not made it properly, you would have faced a lot of problem. So, press it.
same here as well. Do whichever way you like. Press this or press that. That you need to press it somehow. And if you have put this thing correctly, if you have pressed those things the way I showed you, it should be a very easy task. If not, it would become a very, very difficult task. So, you know, yeah. See, I made sure that, you know, I did not put it like this. I made sure holes are on the top. Holes are on the top here. Same here. Okay. Okay. There's something to note though. When you do this thing, there are two sides to this mat. One has this, you know, two different color shades. Like, you know, it's folding here. And this is the more part. So this is going to be on the top. So when you put this thing, when you're doing this part, make sure you're not doing it opposite way. You're not basically putting it the reverse way. It's not noticeable immediately, but it's still slightly noticeable. That this is the top part and this is the bottom part. So you basically want the top part here. The top part is like one which is like, you know, completely straight, and it wraps at the bottom. So yeah. And once you have done this thing, just put it on the floor here and just press it. The reason you are doing this thing is because even though you put all the holes correctly, they might still be slightly unaligned. Like for example, it could be something like this. And putting it like this on the floor at the end will make sure that all of these are aligned and like in a plane. They are not turned around a bit. Slightly rotated of sort. So you can see at the end of this thing, I have made this one layer. Holes. Two holes on the top. Right? As long as you do this, you have not made a mistake. Now, you are going to keep this on the side. You're going to make the same things again. Set of four. Put this on the right. This on the left. Take this one. Make sure it is on the top. The top part is on the top. Once again, the top part is on the top. And this set of four that I had made, this thing is at the bottom, and in all the four cases the holes are on the top. And I'm going to connect and make three more of the things that I had just made before. Okay, now you can see I wanted you to, if you have made this thing, I wanted to compare and make sure everything is good. You can see holes are on the top. You should have this thing, six holes on the top. If you are matching this thing, then you are doing something right. Also, while putting these two, joining two, I did have faced a little bit of resistance. So you do need to pull, not too much, just slight pull, but you will face resistance. So I definitely want to warn you. Now one thing I want to show you something. So you can see this thing is not flat. You can see it is like doing this thing, which means I want you to turn this around and do something like this and just rotate it slightly, right? You need to just play with it a bit, but once you have played with it and rotated it, now you see it is balanced in every place. When you have like a chair and, you know, it's not aligned properly, it might, you know, shake a little, and you don't want that. Same is case here. For all the four I've done this. I've turned it around on a hardwood floor and I've done this to make sure that it is flat and just arranged it a bit. Now once you have done this, you can just keep one of this. And you need to take four of these rods here, right? Rod one. This is the C, rod C, the smallest, small ones. And you're going to just connect all of these rods here. In all of these holes that you have just made. Right? So, six here. You need to press it. I like to turn it around and do it on the carpet like this. And you can see, I can actually press it and it goes inside. You can actually feel it go inside. If you have done it correctly, everything is good. If not, you might just want to do this thing carefully. Once again, turn it around and you can notice something. It is not balanced. So I'm going to, and you can see I balanced it myself. I made it flat. So you need to do this. But as long as you do this, you are fine. Now, obviously, keep this one. You are going to do for three of these. And the fourth one will lay on the top. So do this for the three and then I'm going to show you how to connect all of those. Okay? So you see I made three of these, right? And not one of this has this kind of thing. Now you can cut it, but I don't like to. I like to, you know, in few years when I forget about this thing, I want to see what brand this is. And having this thing really helps to make it for warranty or extra, whatever purpose. I don't like to cut it, but I want to make sure this is on the second or third shelf or bottom shelf, not on the top shelf. So this part, I am using it as a part of this thing and not as the final one. And once again, right, note, put this down and arrange it and make sure that all of them are flat. I've tested all the three and they are all flat. Once you have done this, you can just start connecting, putting this thing one on top of another. So you can see, this is exactly the same as the bottom one, is exactly the same as the second one. It just goes on top of one another. And now you're going to do this. And then you are going to do this. So let me connect this and then I will show you the final part. Okay, now one thing to note when you are connecting these three things. Put these rods in the hole, but don't put them all the way. Just put it in slightly. Just slightly. You want all the six holes to go in slightly inside this one another first. So you can see, note what I am doing here. I am putting them slightly in. I'm also going to do the same thing here. I'm going to show you much better here. Slightly in and slightly. Once all the six are slightly inside the holes, right? Then you go and start pressing. Otherwise, you might have a little bit of difficulty. Not too much, but a little bit of difficulty. But if you do it this way, you can be sure that it's going to be a much easier task putting this thing inside. And it will come out much better because it's automatically straight. You don't have to do any extra work later on. So I pressed slightly in all the holes, then I did this, then I pressed all of them to make sure it's completely inside. Now once again, same, this is the final part, this is the top part. So put it slightly in this hole, put this one in the hole, not too much, see I'm not pressing it, I just want to make sure it's slightly in the hole, right? And now here and here, right? Now that's it, right? Now all the six are in the hole slightly. Now press it. Okay, so this one was not in the hole, but I was still able to put it, which is nice. I got lucky. Don't make the same mistake that I did. And you can see at the end of the day, it's not too much shaky. Obviously there is no weight once it's weight, but in general it's flat. Like it's like, you know, I don't need to worry too much about it being shaky. So yeah. Okay. So now let me show it here. Like this. Now the final part. You are going to take this plug and you are going to fill this hole in. There are six of these things and they are going to go in this each of these holes. So it looks nice. Okay, so it was a bit shaky because this part has come out for some reason. So I just fixed it and now it's much better. Yeah, so as you can see, right, stuff that can happen. I just want, you know, it's nice to see when somebody is actually making it, than when you are looking at it, you know, in some brochure. All the issues that can come up. So looks like all of these are good now. Yep, now I'm going to place this thing in here. Yep, you see, after I press it, you don't even know it's a separate part. It just looks like it goes inside this thing. I'm going to do the same thing for the other six. Okay, so I'm going to put this in the garage, but I wanted to just show you something quickly. It's kind of cold outside, so I'm not going to put it in the garage right now. But you can see, these are shoes and these are my wife's shoes and they're slightly larger in size. But you can see, they both fit in quite comfortably. The normal shoes, as well as these ones. Now obviously if you have like really large snowshoes, they might not go in. So you know, I want you to make sure that you know, you are aware of this if you are making a shoe rack. But to me, since it's going to be in the garage and not in my, like you know, in my, to me that is fine because I can always put the larger shoes on top and it does not look so bad. And look at it, there is so much space. So like we have five people living in the house, we all have different shoes,
And I think, but this is more than enough, right? Two shoes for each, every person. Even then, like, you know, they're like six for five people, like six holes, so one will be extra, and you can always keep our snowshoes on the top. So there's like way more space than I require. And you can see I have not even putting it like this. If I were to just put it slightly arranged, technically I can put more shoes here, right? Three in each. There's just no reason why you cannot do that. So it's like really long and large as well. So I like this, overall I like this way. And I'm very happy with it. Okay, thank you.